So it's like when you add value, you get form.
Oh.
So like if you have a circle, that's just a circle. But when you add value, which is like shading and tone, so there's a mid-tone and it gets darker here, it's not a circle anymore, it's a sphere. Right? So. Do y'all want to try another one on the sheet? And then we'll do one together.
Like choose another prompt?
Huh? Yeah.
Confusion, maybe? Is that too hard?
For line.
Using line to show confusion. Okay. So, to think about confusion, what's the opposite of confusion? Like?
Understanding,
knowing where you're going. So,
the line would be straight, but...
Yeah. So, to show confusion, instead of a straight line, you might have...
Squiggles.
Or a spiraling line. And that might show, like... And this suggests, like, I don't know what direction I'm going. When you don't know what direction you're going in, that shows confusion. Whereas if you're showing clarity or understanding or knowing where you're going, you might have one straight line. Or you might have back to the horizon that we were using earlier, two straight lines going to the same point. So you're using lines to suggest I know where I'm going. And here, we don't know what's happening. That is just confusion, right? Do y'all want to cover another one before we draw some art? Like, we practice drawing them?
I think we got it.
Think you got it? Okay. And we'll continue to cover these throughout the unit as y'all complete your sketch journals. But, okay. So, let's choose one. Like, y'all can choose one together to do. And you're going to do it in your own sketch journal. And I'm going to help you. So this is just practice, this is the space where you can ask questions, where you can run suggestions by me or whatever. I don't want all of y'all to look the same because you're different people, you have different experiences, you have different perspectives on confusion and anger and sadness. But so now is the time that you can practice that. So what's one that y'all want to do? Then let's decide on one together and then y'all can do individual ones.
Music.
Using shape to suggest music. Okay. What are some ideas you have to do that?
I mean, you could draw like music notes. That shape?
Music notes, yeah. That's a shape. Mm-hmm. What else? What do you think of Corey?
Yeah.
I kind of think of like the bar. What do you call that?
Yeah,
the lines that
the clef.
The clefs, the bar, the measures.
Yeah. And like when you hear music, like is music really a straight line? Is music really a square?
No. You usually see it like kind of like in squiggles, like waves.
Squiggles, waves, maybe a spiral. It kind of depends on the kind of music, right?
Yeah.
You might see if it's rock and roll or something really loud, you might
see
stars.
There's
a lot. Oh yeah.
And what'd you say? You said waves?
Yeah, kind of like with like the wave of the music.
What kind of music do you think shows waves?
I guess like slower.
Slow, maybe jazz.
Slow.
I think it's jazz.
Jazz.
Mellow. Mm-hmm. Right. Yeah. So, music definitely isn't stuck to the five bars. Like when you think of visually, what is it? Visual shapes does it give you? So you guys can start drawing those ideas.